Hello everyone, this is a new series which we are starting today on Words, where we will be focused on coding problem asked by top MNC companies during interviews. We will be covering the interview problems topic wise. So this is the sequence which we are going to follow. Firstly, we are going to solve array problems, then we are going to solve a string problem, then stack and queue, then linked list. Then we are going to solve problem on trees, then binary search trees, then sorting, then heap, then tries, then backtracking, hashing, dynamic programming, and graph. So this series is going to cover all the concepts. So if we solve all the problems from this seat, we will be able to crack any coding interview problems. So we are going to start with array. So before going into the problem, please subscribe to our channel for more interesting coding content. Now let's talk about today's problem. Given n non-negative integers representing an elevation map, where the width of each bar is 1, compute how much water it can trap after raining. So here we are given a bar graph where the width of each bar is 1. And we need to find out how much water this whole bar graph can hold. The height of each bar is given by this integer array height. So this first bar is having height 0, the second bar is having height 1, again the third bar is having height 0, and the fourth bar is having height 2, again this fifth is having height 1, 6 is 0. So this height array is defining the height of each bar, and the width of each bar is 1. So firstly we will try to solve the simpler version of this, that is how much water a particular bar can hold. So let's suppose this is our current bar for which we are trying to compute how much water it can store. So to hold water on this current bar, we need a height elevation in the left direction and we need a height elevation in the right direction of this bar. Then only we will be able to store some water. Otherwise, we will not be able to store the water on this bar. So if this is my current bar, so this is our current bar and we are trying to store some water on this current bar. So we need a height elevation in the left direction and in the right direction. Then only we will be able to store some water in it. Otherwise, we will not be able to store water in it. Because if there is no height elevation in the left direction or in the right direction, then the water will spill off. So what I am trying to say, if this is our current bar and all the bar in the left side are smaller than this, then we are not going to store this is our current bar. So if we are trying to hold some water in it, we are not able to do so. Why? Because the water will spill off in the left direction because there is no boundary, because there is no elevation in the left direction. To store water, we need to create a container. So this is the base. And we need a blockage from the left and right direction. So this blockage we can only create when there will be have a bar which has a height greater than this current bar. Because this is our base. If all the bars will have height equal to this base only, we will not be able to store the water. So we need a bar in the left direction which will having a height greater than this. Then only we can create an elevation in the left direction, and similar the case for the right direction. The first point is clear. To compute the water that can be held on a bar, we need to find out what is the maximum bar in the left direction of the current bar and what is the maximum height bar in the right direction of the current bar. Now coming to the second thing, how much water it can hold. So let's suppose this is our maximum bar in the left side, so its height is L. And this is our current bar which is having height C. Maximum height bar in the right direction which is having height R. So now we are trying to find out how much water we can hold here. So the quantity of water that we can store here will be equal to minimum of left and right minus C. So this will be the quantity of water which we can store on this current bar. So the first thing is for each bar we need to find out its left max and its right max. And then we are going to find how much water that bar can contain using this formula. So for finding the left max and right max for a particular bar, we need to traverse the whole bar. So if this is my So if this is my current bar and I'm trying to find out its left max and its right max, so I need to go to entire left direction for finding its left max, and we need to go for its entire right direction for finding its right max. So here we can find right max, and here we can find its left max. So we need to traverse this complete height array for finding the left max and right max for one bar. And we need to repeat this process for each bar, because we are trying to find out how much water the whole bar graph can hold. So we need to compute for each bar. So what will be the time complexity for this approach? So for finding one bar, we are taking O(n) time. We need one linear traversal of this height array. So for n bar, we need O(n) square, because O(n) into O(n) will become O(n) square. So this will be our time complexity of this brute force way of solving. And the space complexity will be O(1). We are not using any extra space. So this was the solution of brute forcing this problem. So now we'll talk about the second solution. So now we are not going to compute this left max and right max each time. We'll pre-compute this left max and right max for each bar initially. Then we are going to compute how much water each bar can contain. So we are going to create two arrays. One is going to hold our left max for each bar, and the other one is going to contain right max for each bar. So here we are trying to compute our left max for each bar. So we are going to start from our left direction. So initially the left max for the first bar will be this current bar itself. So if this is 2, so this will be 2. Now we'll shift for the next bar. So we'll check whether this previous value and this current bar, which one is bigger. So here the previous is bigger one. So we are going to store the previous value as a left max for this current bar. Again, similar thing for the next. So we are going to compare with the previous max and the current bar. So the previous one is bigger one. So we are going to store 2 as a left max for the current bar. Compare this current bar and the previous. So the current bar is having more height. So this is going to have 3. Similarly, we can compute the right max for each bar by going in the reverse direction from right to left. So we'll compute this thing. So initially, for initial, it will be 3. Now we'll compute to this next graph. So which one is bigger, this or this computed value? So that we are going to store 3 here again. So this is our right max for each graph. Now we have computed our left max and right max. Now we can easily compute how much water each bar can hold. The minimum of these two is 2, and the height of current bar is 2 itself. So the water it can hold will be 0. Now for the second index, the minimum is 2, and the height of this current and the height of this bar is 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. Now again we shift for the next index. So the minimum is 2 and the height of current bar is 1. So the water it can hold is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. Now again similar thing we are going to do for the last bar graph. But it's 3. So 3 is the minimum one and height is also 3. So it's going to store 0 water. So the output for this will be 2. So what will be the time and space complexity for this approach? So it is going to take O(n) time, because we can compute this left max in one traversal, this right max also in one linear traversal, even the water that can be accumulated by each bar in just one linear traversal. So it's 3n. So basically we can say it's big O of n, and the space complexity will be O(n), because here we are creating two arrays which is going to store the left max and the right max for each bar. So this is going to cost us O(n) space. But now we can do our calculation in O(n) time. We can solve this problem using a stack also, but I'm not going to discuss about the stack approach. I will discuss this stack approach when I will be in the stack section. But can we do better? So we need to come up with the best feature of these two solutions. So now we are going to do the dry run of our algorithm which we have just developed.
So this algorithm is going to take own time and own space complexity. So this is not the optimized way to solve this problem. We are going to discuss the optimized way to solve this problem in the next video. So for this video, we are going to take this height array as our example. And we are going to implement our algorithm on this example. So we are going to implement our first step. So firstly, we need to find the highest bar from the left side for each bar. For example, if we are trying to find the highest bar from the left side for the third bar, so that will be equal to 2. So this is our 0 bar, this is our first bar, this is our second, and this is our third bar. And the height of these are 0, 1, 0, and 2. So if we are trying to find the left max for this third bar, so this will be equal to the maximum from 0 to 3. So we are including this third bar also. So that is 2. So that's why the left max for third index is 2. Similarly, we are going to find the highest bar from the right side for each bar. And we need to note that we are including that bar also in that calculation. Now, after finding the left max and right max, we need to calculate the water stories on each bar. So we are going to calculate the water stories on each bar using this formula. So this will be the left max after the calculation, and this will be the right max, and this will be the water stories on each bar, which is equal to 6. Now let's code this problem.
So we are going to pre-calculate the left max and right max for each bar. So let's firstly create our left max right max array, in which we are going to store the left max and right max for each bar. So we have created our left max and right max list. Now we are going to calculate our left max and right max values. So for that we need one traversal of our height array. So let's do the linear traversal of height array. So for the first bar, the left max height will be the bar itself. So that's why we are starting our loop from the first index, not from the zero index. And similarly, we are going to calculate our right max for each bar, just going through in the reverse direction. So for the last bar, the right max height will be the last bar itself. So that's why we are considering from the second last bar, not the last bar. Now we are going to implement our final step, that how much water on each bar we are going to store. So we are going to create a variable result, which is going to keep all the water accumulated on each bar. And lastly, we are going to return our result. So here I forgot to put our decrement operator. So let's put -1. Now let's run our code. Yeah, so it's giving us correct thing. So let's submit our code. So it's got submitted, but it's not that efficient, and even the space complexity is also not good, because we are taking own space and own time complexity. So yeah, that's it for this video. If you found this video useful, please do like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you for listening. See you next time.